वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, आई एम राजदीप आचार्य एंड टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टी सेल एक्टिवेशन। सो हाउ टी सेल गेट्स एक्टिवेटेड। सपोज इट इज ए पी सी सेल। ए पी सी सेल स्टैंड फॉर एंटीजन प्रेजेंटिंग सेल एंड इट इज फॉरेन एंटीजन। सपोज इट इज ए फॉरेन एंटीजन। सो इट इज APC cell. We know that APC cells are macrophage. APC cells are also NK cell and they are also dendritic cell. So these are the APC cell, antigen presenting cell. So at first the APC cell will engulf this pathogen, I mean the foreign vascular antigen, through phagocytosis. So the APC cell will engulf this foreign particle through the phagocytosis and it will process this foreign particle, the foreign vascular antigen, through some enzyme and will convert this into small peptide. So now this foreign particle, foreign antigen, is now converted into some small peptide. Now what will happen next? The APC cell will express this foreign particle, the foreign antigen, on its cell surface through MHC class 2. So it is the MHC class 2 through which the APC cell will express the foreign particle, the foreign antigen, on its cell surface for further action. So it is the small peptide that have been processed in our APC cell. Now what will happen next? This is the inactivated T cell. It is actually inactivated CT cell. It is a inactivated T cell. The T cell will attach to the MHC. MHC class 2. So the T cell will attach to the MHC class 2 through the TCR receptor. So the T cell will attach with the MHC class 2 for the further action for this vascular antigen, the foreign particle that have been converted into small peptide. So the T cell have been attached with this MHC class 2 through this TCR, T cell receptor. But now this engagement between the MHC class 2 and the TCR is not strong enough for further action. So this engagement is not strong enough for the further processing. So what will happen next? Two co-stimulatory reaction will happen here, that are the it is CD 40. It is CD 40. So the CD 40 from MHC, sorry, the CD 40 from MHC or NK cell or dendritic cell, any kind of cell, I mean the APC cell, the CD 40 from ABC cell will attach with the CD40L. The CD40L of T cell. So the CD40 from APC cell attach with the CD40L of T cell. It is the first co-stimulatory reaction. So it is the first co-stimulatory reaction where CD40 attach with CD40L. Now what will happen next? The second co-stimulatory reaction is the B7 from APC cell. So it is the B7 from the APC cell. So it is B7. From APC cell will attach to CD28 of T cell. So the B7 from APC cell will attach to the CD28 of T cell. It is another second co-stimulatory reaction. For the confirmation of the strong engagement between MHC class 2 and TCR, T cell receptor of T cell. So it is CD28. Now what will happen next after these two co-stimulatory reaction? Finally, the CD4 ligand will attach with this engagement. The CD4 ligand is something like that. So this is the CD4 ligand which will attach with it. For the final confirmation of this engagement between MHC class 2 and TCR. This is the final confirmation. Now what will happen next? The APC cell. So the APC cell will secrete interleukin 12. So the APC cell, it is the APC cell, will secrete interleukin 12, which will attach on the surface of interleukin 12 receptor that is present on T cell. It will attach to the interleukin 12 receptor that is present on the T cell. Now when this interleukin 12 will attach on the receptor of the that is present on the T cell will induce and it will secrete interleukin 2, and this interleukin 2 will attach on interleukin 2 receptor that is present on the T cell. So the interleukin 12, the interleukin 12 act as a paracrine fashion, but the interleukin 12 act as a the interleukin 12 act as a autocrine fashion. That means the interleukin 12 secret from that cell that it is going to attach. Now what will happen next? The T cell, the CD4 T cell will secret interferon gamma. The interferon gamma is released from T cell and it will attach to the APC cell. The interferon gamma will help to recruit more APC cell. That means the T cell is released the interferon gamma and it is going to attach on the surface of APC cell like macrophage, like NK cell, like dendritic cell, and it is signaling that to recruit more APC cell for more further action of this foreign antigen, the foreign vascular antigen or the foreign particles. So at the same time, the interleukin 12 along with interleukin 1 along with interleukin 4 and also interleukin 5 will secrete from T cell. So it is CD4 T cell. So at the same time, when the interferon gamma will secrete, at the same time interleukin 1, interleukin 4 and interleukin 5 will secrete. The function of interleukin 1 is activation of CD8 T cell. That means the cytotoxic T cell, and the function of interleukin 5, interleukin 4 along with this interleukin 2 is to activate B cell that will further divide into memory B cell and plasma B cell. We know that the plasma B cell will secrete antibody to kill this pathogen. And if this pathogen is intracellular, then the CD4 T cell will active and will secrete interleukin 1 that will active the CD8 T cell, and then that CD8 T cell will attach with this intracellular pathogen and will kill this pathogen. So this is the schematic diagram about how T cell get activated and they will kill the pathogen. So I hope you guys have understand, and if you guys like this channel, then do subscribe and follow us. And also we have our Facebook channel, that is Era of Zoology. There we provide books and also notes. Thank you so much.